I really felt like Oprah, like I was giving away cards. Like people were so excited to hear our voice when we called them. I mean, it kind of like, yes. And I was like, you get a car and you get a car. It was so funny.
You get an appointment. You get an appointment. Hi, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Samantha Pearlman and I'm a realtor located in Central New Jersey. Welcome to the new series on my channel where I'm highlighting small and local business owners here in Central New Jersey. This is video 2. In this video, I sit down with Stefanie Savino, owner of Bella Rococo at Emilia's in Garwood. She's going to share about her journey about joining the industry and becoming a salon owner. I hope you enjoy.
Hi, Stefanie. Thanks so much for sitting down with me.
Hi, Samantha. Nice to see you again, as always.
I know. Good to see you. I miss you.
Miss you too.
So let's talk a little bit. Let's go back to, you know, before where you are today and talk about why you got into the business and how you got into the business.
So for me, ironically, this wasn't my first starting point in terms of what do I want to be when I grow up. I went to college. I got a degree in criminal justice. I really thought I was going to go into law enforcement. Although I'm not doing that, I still love that I went to school for that because it really interested me and I love Law and Order SVU. But I wanted to join the beauty industry because of my obsession with Marilyn Monroe and like the glamour and the glitz. And I just loved how you could change people with like hair and makeup. So I went to school. First time in beauty school was for aesthetics. And that pretty much covers skincare, makeup, and waxing. Mm-hmm. And in 2008, I decided to go back for the full cosmetology license, which is skincare, makeup, and nails. Skincare, waxing, and nails. Yeah, so it's everything. Because you could do different parts of it. And I was working full-time and then at a salon part-time. And when I turned 30, I was like, you know what? I really want to do hair full-time. So I took the leap and I was like, I believe in myself. I'm just going to go for it. If I don't go it now, I'm never going to be able to go. And I was at that salon for about 10 years. And then last year, I knew I wanted to start opening. And it's crazy because I thought I would be opening in 2020. So thank God the universe knew to be like 2019. Last spring, I knew I wanted to start the process of opening. And I said, oh, I'll go to Aunt Amelia. She's had a salon forever. Just pick her brain. And I went to the salon, but there was nothing really happening here. And I'm like, that's strange. Like, what are they doing in there? And she goes, no, they're renting it. But I didn't know that. So it's just crazy how things turn out and plan out for how they're supposed to lay out for you. Mm-hmm. So it was very, very quick and very, very not so planned, but I signed my lease and I was just like, you know what? I'm going to go for it. This is the time. I really love the energy of this space. And on June 4th, we opened Bella Rococo at Emilia's and we just had our year anniversary June 4th. So it's been a really crazy time.
Happy anniversary. Happy one
year. Thank you.
For your business.
Yeah. Exciting time. Especially to be a business that sustained during the pandemic as a new business, because unfortunately a lot of people aren't making it. And I'm just really proud that we're here. We're coming back stronger and, you know, we're able to continue what we love to do, which is make people feel beautiful. So we're excited to come back.
So let's talk about that, you know, in between time a little bit, because you have been shut down for a while. And you're right. That was one of the things that I have always admired about you is your strength and perseverance and motivation and ability to be able to pivot during difficult times and changing times. And you jumped right in and you did a bunch of stuff, you know, during the shutdown to propel your business forward. Why don't you share a little bit about that?
So we shut down March 17th. New Jersey shut salons down March 19th. I really thought, it's so funny. I was like, oh, we're going to be gone for 3 weeks. Like, it'll be 3 weeks. It'll be fine. Everyone have a little time off. I mean, if you would have told me 4 months, I would have never believed you. So very quickly, early on, we had to really strategize as the third week hit that we're not coming out of this right now. And we're not like other businesses that can do takeout or curbside. I mean, people only buy like so much shampoo. So we worked with our first distribution company, True Beauty Concepts, in having an e-commerce store, which was great because we were able to market more than what we offer here, all kinds of different products and tools, and gain a commission from that. We also partnered with bringing in our makeup and skincare line, Line Life by Alcone, which was great because we didn't have to drive around and drop anything off. It was totally contactless, which everybody thought was just great because We didn't have to go out. They didn't have to go out. So it was awesome. The other thing which really helped us was joining Think Design Print, which is a marketing company in Cranford. They created Jersey Strong Local, which they had businesses just come to them. They put your logo on your shirt, $20, 10 for them, 10 for us. And we did really, really well. We're still number 5 out of all the businesses, and we're not even in Cranford. So I thought that was like super cool.
Got my big,
yeah. Our big heavy hitter moment though was our Root touch-up color kits, where we partnered with DP Hue, because it really not only helped us gain revenue, but people feel better, because after a while it kind of wears on you. I mean, I hate to say we're vain, but it's not a vanity. I think it's just, it gave you something to feel better in the midst of being in quarantine. And of course, people purchased gift certificates, which was greatly appreciated. So those three things, like 4 or 5 things, really helped pivot to help us gain some kind of revenue, because, you know, rent still had to get paid, utilities still had to get paid. So we're coming in at a point where we were very fortunate of those efforts to help us get to, now we can reopen and we're not so far behind, you know, so that was really good.
Yeah, that's great. And it's great that not only can you still assist your clients, you can still be taking care of your employees, you can be moving the business forward and helping the community, and the community
exactly.
Can you. So it's a great example of how, you know, a successful business like yourself has been able to survive during everything that's going on.
It's so funny to say that, because we're reopening June 23rd, and you know, social media is huge for business, as you know, with real estate. And in the beginning, I'm like, are people even going to want to look at hair pictures? Like, should we? But I was very much, no, you need to show that you're here. You need to still be relevant. And we have been able to attract more new business, more new, like we've had at least 20 new clients call, like that are even going to wait. So I think whenever you're in business, the takeaway for anyone watching this is just always stay true to who you are and just constantly just put your best foot forward and showcase who you are. And people really appreciate that and they'll support it, you know? So that's my biggest takeaway, was if you ever doubt yourself, just go, because it's going to pay off in the long run. And if not, then, I mean, you tried. The worst that can happen is somebody says no. And you're like, all right, that's fine. Next, like somebody else will say yes, it's fine.
So let's talk about the reopening, because nobody is more excited than I am about yes. Reopening. So talk a little bit about when it's happening and what it's going to look like.
Sure. So the state of New Jersey for beauty industry is allowed to reopen June 22nd. We are never open on Monday, so we are opening Tuesday, June 23rd. The way it's going to look is all the stations have been 6 feet apart. We have, when you first come in, it'll be a safety check. So you will first call before you come in, just to let us know that you're here. And if we're ready to take you, you will come in, because the waiting rooms are non-existent as of right now due to keeping social distancing and maintaining the amount of people in the shop at one time. So when you come in, you will sanitize or wash your hands. You will get a temperature check, and you do have to fill out a quick questionnaire. You'll then get escorted. You'll get your service done. While you're processing, we'll be rebooking you, doing your retail suggestions and purchases, and then pre-booking your next appointment. And then we're shooting more for contactless payments, so more credit over cash. We are not accepting checks at this time, but we would accept cash if that's how you choose to pay. We are only allowed to do one person at a time per technician, so it's not going to be that many people at one time, where most salons can double book, meaning if you're processing your color, I can do a haircut while you're processing. You're literally with that person for the entire duration, so that's why a lot of salons don't have immediate availability, because you have to crowd control. However, we're taking it as an opportunity to totally rebrand the experience and really hone in on one person and give them the best. So this, I feel like, don't be mad if you have to wait. Look at it as this is your time to really change it up, and you have your stylist like 100% attention, and you're getting us fresh off of quarantine, and we're just ready to go in. The other things to consider is you would only be able to come by yourself unless you're accompanying a child for a cut or an elderly person. And we're not going to be doing our complimentary treats and beverages at this time. That will come back as we get more along. There's no real difference. And the only two services we cannot really do at this time is our spray tan service and our makeup service, because if you have to take the mask off, you can't do it. I'm sure that'll get lessened as we move into phase three, but everything else we're able to do. Dom is back too. Everyone was asking about Dominique, our esthetician. She'll be doing lashes, brows, body waxing. So we're really, really excited to have everyone in there and make it as safe and clean as possible. And just to add, our entire team did go through the Barberside COVID-19 sanitary and disinfection certification. Everybody has their certification. And we do have a cleaning company that comes every single week. We got a little certificate that we've been highly, like majorly deep clean disinfected. So you're come here, you'll be good. So everybody, we're going to be safe. We'll take care of you guys and we'll have a safe and fun environment again. So it'll be good. We're excited.
So what you just said though, a fun environment, that is always what you get when you come.
We try.
It feels like a fit. Like for those of you out there that if you've never, visited Bella Rococo, it's fun. It feels like family. You feel welcome and warm. And no matter what is happening, I know that you're going to continue that.
Yeah, we're going to have our music. We're all going to be fighting over the radio. We'll have our bath and body candles, you know, even though we have our mask, everybody has like really fun masks. So it'll be really, really great.
So everybody, I'm going to have all of Stephanie's links in the description box below to contact her, contact the salon, you know, email, social media, things like that. But why don't you talk a little bit about the information that I'm sharing below?
Sure. So we are very big on social. So you can follow us on our Instagram, which is at Bella Rococo Beauty. Sam will link the spelling. Our Facebook is the same thing, facebook.com/Bella Rococo. Twitter, it's Bella Rococo. And if you are a client and you get our emails, we do have an email list as well for all our clients to keep you informed. And our website is www.bellarococohairmakeup.com. And it has our service menu, what we offer, our specials. You get to meet the team. And yeah, if you ever have any questions, Sam will link our phone number and our email. Just send it over and I'll be more than happy to answer any of your questions.
Great. And before you opened the salon, you were doing hair and makeup for weddings and special events and stuff like that. Yeah. So I know that, you know, things around COVID have changed a lot, but somebody might be watching this video, let's say a year from now, and they have a wedding or an event coming up. Why don't you share a little bit about that if that's something you're interested in?
Sure. So if you are getting married or anyone you know is getting married, we would love to be a part of your special day. We have over 15 years of wedding hair and makeup industry experience. We've been ranked the best of the best on the Knot, the Wedding Wire, multiple years. We actually just got asked to go to the Knot Gala last year, which is an invite only for their top vendors. So pretty much for on site, you can either come here and do your hair and makeup or we go to you. We travel to wherever you're getting married. We also have spray tanning, which is on site, and we can do it for your party a couple days before the event. We have a really good bridal package. So if you know of anyone getting married or you're getting married, contact us and I'd love to speak with you on how we can make you look amazing on your special day. And it's not just for weddings. We go for sweet 16s, prom. So our just biggest market's bridal. But if you have anything on site, we can go.
Well, thank you so much for sitting down and chatting and sharing the story with you. If you're watching this and you want to book an appointment with Stephanie or anybody in her team for the salon, go ahead and check out the contact information in the description box below. Or like she said, if you have a wedding or event or something coming up in the future, they're happy to serve and make you feel beautiful on your special day. Make sure you reach out to Stephanie.
Thank you, Sam. Have a good day, everybody. Bye.
Thank you so much for watching, and a huge thank you and shout out to Stephanie for taking the time to sit down and chat with me, share a little bit about her story, her journey, and her business. I know we all look forward to her being able to reopen. I'm really loving sitting down with all of the local entrepreneurs and small businesses in my area, and if you yourself are a small business or an entrepreneur in Central New Jersey, or you know somebody that is, and you'd like to be featured on this channel, be sure to reach out to me. I've got all my contact information below as well. And if you haven't already done so, consider hitting that subscribe button and the bell so you don't miss the new videos I release every week. As I previously mentioned, these small business highlight videos, they don't have a set release schedule. They will be released as I'm able to sit down with each business owner. Stay safe, everybody, and thank you for watching.
So everyone always asks me, what is Bella Rococo? So my sister, Nikki, actually helped name my business. Well, you know, Bella is Italian, it's beautiful. And then she's like, Rococo is a type of art that is very colorful and extravagant and just like extra. And she's like, that's you. And that's like glam. And I'm like, oh, I like that. And then when we opened the salon, it's at Emilia's to honor my Aunt Emilia, who owns the salon before me and owned the building. And then her salon was Emilia's Coiffure.